Myself Darshana More, Assistant Professor of Food Science, KKV College of Horticulture, Nasik. Today I am going to discuss about another topic, seed dormancy. Seed dormancy means inability of a certain seed to germinate readily even when they are provided with all conditions required for germination. Dormancy may be due to the conditions associated either with the seed itself or with existing environmental factors such as temperature, moisture and light. The dormancy means that the resting period of seed. The general structure of seed. General structure of seeds is first testa, endosperm, aileron layer, radical, epicotyl and cotyledon. The first testa means usually outer or hard coat of seed is called testa. Then endosperm, that means the part of seed which act as a food store for the developing plant embryo, usually containing a starch with protein and other nutrients. Then aileron layer, that means the outermost layer of endosperm. Then radicals. The radicals means the root forming parts of the seed embryo. Then epicotyl means the above region of cotyledon, and the cotyledon means the first leaves appears from the seed germination. The causes of dormancy or the factor affecting dormancy. First, seed coat dormancy, rudimentary embryo due to dormancy. Then dormancy due to chemical inhibitors, dormancy due to internal factors, dormancy due to low temperature and light sensitive seeds. First, seed coat dormancy. It is due to the seed coat or other tissue covering the embryo, which hard and are impermeable to water and oxygen, which prevents germination. Example, Malvaceae family. Then it is also the seed coat are apparently permeable to water and gases, but they are so hard to resist the embryo expansion. Examples, pits of stone fruits and shell of nuts. Next, dormancy due to rudimentary embryos. That means that some plants shed their fruits before the embryo within the seed has attained the maturity stage to germinate. Such a seeds require several months or the several weeks after harvest to attain its full maturity so that it can germinate. Examples, pinus species and palms. Dormancy due to chemical inhibitors. In certain species, specific chemical substances that prevent germination occur in the seed coat, endosperm or the embryos. For the elimination of chemicals, we can use the leaching with water and absorption of water. Then the dormancy due to internal factors. It is due to the physiological dormancy, dormant embryo. In case the dormant embryos do not resume active growth, even though all environmental conditions favorable, unless the seed are subject to moist chilling treatment. Freshly harvested seeds of apple, grapes, peaches and apricot. Next, factors. Double dormancy means the some species exhibit both seed coat dormancy and embryo dormancy. Examples are Circes occidentalis. Low temperature. All seeds require the specific temperature for the germination. In a certain plants, the seed remain dormant after the harvest because they require low temperature for the germination. Light sensitive seeds. In a certain seed, the germination is affected by the light, so the absence of light results in a seed dormancy. There are two conditions in light sensitive seeds. First, photoblastic seeds. That means where in light, some seeds are light inhibits the seed germination so that negatively affects. That means in a light, the seed do not germinate. It's called negatively photoblastic effect, and the seeds which are sensitive to sunlight are termed as photoblastic seeds. Methods of overcome the dormancy. First, mechanical scarification. In mechanical scarification, rubbing, piercing, then sandpaper, it's used for mechanical scarification. Soaking in water, then acid treatment. For the acid treatment, we use the hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid. Cold scarification, dry storage and treatment with alkali. First, mechanical scarification. It includes breaking or scratching the seed coat mechanically to modify the hard or impervious seed coat. This can be done easily by revolving the seed in a drum lined with sandpaper. Then soaking in water. Generally, seed we will be soak in hot water for a few seconds and then soak for 24 hours in a cold water, which make the seed coat to get often and soften and wash off the incubators. Example, betel seeds. In some cases, the seeds are soaked in a running cold water for a period of 8 to 12 hours, which helps in removing the inhibitors. Next, acid treatment. Soaking the seed for the few seconds, 15 to 60 seconds only, in a concentrated hydrochloric acid or the sulfuric acid modifies the hard or impermeable seed covering. At the end of treatment period, the seed are washed to remove the remnant acids. Then cold stratification, that means during stratification, the seeds are exposed to abundant moisture, ample oxygen and relatively cold temperature. For the stratification, we use the cold temperature. It consists of placing the seeds in a moist medium of sand, peat vermiculite and holding at temperature slightly above freezing. This time varies from 1 to 4 months depending upon the type of seeds. During this process, the level of endogenous growth promoting substances, examples gibberellic acid and cytokinin, increases, while the level of growth inhibiting hormones like abscisic acid decreases, this removing the block and permitting germination, examples peaches. Then dry storage. It promotes the after ripening in a certain seed which are dormant when freshly harvested. Examples, papaya seeds. Freshly harvested seeds of many annuals and herbaceous plants fails to germinate until after period of dry storage. Such a post-harvest dormancy may last few days to several months. And last one, treatment with chemicals. Soaking in a potassium nitrate 0.2% and gibberellic acid 200 to 500 ppm or thiourea 0.2% solution prior to sowing has been found to stimulate germination of different kinds of seeds. And for the instance, soaking of seed in a gibberellic acid stimulates the germination for many citrus species. With example, trifoliate orange, Rangpur lime, sweet orange and sour orange. This is all about seed dormancy. Thank you.